Piktochart is an online platform for creating infographics and visualizations. It is a third-party software, so you will need to carefully read the terms and conditions and the privacy policy and create an account if you agree to those. I've logged into my Piktochart account and immediately you get presented with all the different formats that you can create. Now, I have a free account, so I won't have access to all the functionality on a paid-for platform. I want to create an infographic. So I'm going to choose infographic from the top, and I'm going to use one of the templates here, a business basic template. So this is quite a detailed editor, but you can see here that the template has laid out on the page some boxes that can be changed and tweaked for your purpose. So let's start at the top. You click to select any block and then you can edit the text. So I'm going to put in here how to make tea. The first step for me, I'm going to put in here as boil the kettle, and I'm going to put my own photo into this just by dragging and dropping the photo from my desktop onto the infographic template, and then I can use this space here to provide further details. So you can add in extra blocks as well, move things down and create quite a long infographic which allows people to scroll through it. So let's assume that I've made my changes for that block, and we can add in extra items here, we can add in further uploads, extra images. We get a limited number of spaces. You probably want to make sure your images are small to begin with. We can change the background images, and extra tools such as videos, maps and charts. If I wanted to create a new block with a chart, just going to click Add block, and I'm going to drag a chart to that block. I can specify here the chart details and the chart type. So I'm going to create a gauge chart, and now I've done that, I can add a title if I wanted to, and then click Insert chart. So that immediately drops in a chart onto your infographic, and you can drag that around, align that center, add in extra text if you want to. So I'm just going to add in some more text. So having a look at these templates, I want something quite clean actually. Some of these are quite fancy. So maybe we just go with a standard text box. We can drag that to wherever we want it to be. We can put some explanation goes here. Okay, so let's save that now at the top of the page. That will save, and then we can preview this to see how it will look to someone on the web. Exit the preview. We now have the options to download it, so we can download as a PNG. You can't download as a PDF in this case, which is the higher quality version. You can only download as a PNG or a JPEG. These are image-based formats, so any of the text in the file will not be accessible to disabled users. So please bear that in mind based upon your audience and the requirements for your work. Where possible, upscale it to the highest level. Obviously, if you've got a paid account, then you can get the higher levels there, which will be useful for printing. But for attaching, perhaps you can embed this within a Word document, choose the highest quality setting there, and then you can download as a PNG. You also can share this online. So I'm going to put in here my example infographic, giving it a title. Then you have the options here to allow it to be unpublished, i.e. it's private to you, and you can only access it when you are logged in, or public on the internet. And this will give a link. I'm going to copy that link and click OK. You can also, you've also got it there. So the best way to check this is to switch into an in-private or an incognito window in your browser to make sure that you're logged out of Piktochart. Paste in the link, and this will show you what you can share with others. Now, it's got the Piktochart banner at the top, but your infographic appears down below.